What if the asteroid wasn't what killed the dinosaurs? 66 million years ago, a vast meteorite the size of Mount Everest hit the Earth, eradicating 75% of living things, especially dinosaurs. But what if I told you that it's possible that the meteorite wasn't the cause of the dinosaurs going extinct? What if dinosaurs were already going extinct long before the meteorite fell? Surprisingly, there is a theory that indicates that it is likely that a meteorite was not the cause of the extinction of the dinosaurs as we thought. Are you ready? Let's go! As we all know, the most anticipated theory today about the extinction of the dinosaurs is the fall of a giant meteorite. If you want to know how scientists came to this conclusion, we recommend you watch the previous video about where was the meteorite that killed the dinosaurs. Today we have enough evidence that suggests that approximately 66 million years ago, a meteorite, at least 10 kilometers in diameter, fell onto Earth. Some of that evidence is the colossal crater of Chicxulub in the Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico, which is the largest on the entire planet, and the date of its creation agrees with the date of the extinction of the dinosaurs. Another proof of the collision of a meteorite of these dimensions on Earth is the excess of iridium in the sedimentary rock that marked the transition of the KT period, a period in which a sudden mass extinction occurred and in which the levels of iridium in the atmosphere suddenly increased. Iridium is a metal found mainly in asteroids. All this suggests that the extinction of the dinosaurs was caused by a space rock that hit the Earth. Still, although this is the most accepted theory today, it's not the only one that scientists have formulated, as other events could also explain the sudden extinction of the dinosaurs. Dinosaurs were already going extinct before the meteorite fell? Some of these theories are based on the fact that researchers tracked the species that appeared and those that disappeared over millions of years, and estimated the rates of speciation and extinction over time. The result shows that dinosaurs were already in decline globally 10 million years before the asteroid impact, affecting both carnivores such as Tyrannosaurus or Tarbosaurus, as well as herbivorous groups such as Triceratops or Diplodocus. According to researchers Fabien Condamine and Guillaume Guinot of the Institute of Evolutionary Sciences in Montpellier, France, 56 million years ago, dinosaur ecosystems began to change and become increasingly cold. Species that fed on plants tended to disappear first, which made later ecosystems unstable and susceptible to collapse if environmental conditions worsened. The lack of herbivorous animals encouraged carnivores to begin migrating to areas with more food, causing an acceleration in the decline of herbivores. Two main factors led to the slow decline of the dinosaurs before the meteorite fell. First, temperatures around the planet gradually became colder, making life more difficult for dinosaurs, which depended on warm temperatures. Remember that contrary to what is thought, even though dinosaurs were reptiles, recent studies show that most of them were endotherms, that is, warm-blooded, so they were accustomed to high temperatures, such as tropical ones. The problem with this is that being so large, herbivores needed large amounts of food to stay at the temperature. It is possible that at that time, the entire planet was entering a climate change that caused a decrease in temperatures and plants. This climate change could have been due to a reorganization of ocean currents that caused the high in tropical temperatures, to which the dinosaurs were accustomed to drop considerably, leaving an average temperature of 7 degrees Celsius in the northern hemisphere and 10 degrees Celsius in the south. This new cold climate and lack of food was a difficult challenge to face for the largest and oldest dinosaurs. They had adapted to a hot climate and abundant food for millions of years, so they could not adapt so quickly to a cold climate. Because of this, the large herbivores began to die from the lack of food and the low temperatures that their bodies were not able to withstand. This broke the trophic chain and triggered a chain of extinctions in which several species of dinosaurs, such as the Triceratops, died. It's possible that all the Triceratops died long before the meteorite fell. The second factor that led to this decline of the dinosaurs was the loss of herbivores. This made the ecosystems unstable and susceptible to a cascading extinction that led the carnivores to fight for the few remaining herbivores. Does this mean that what killed the dinosaurs was climate change and not the meteorite? Not necessarily. The theory holds that dinosaurs began to go extinct long before the meteorite fell, but when the meteorite fell, many species were still beginning to adapt to the new cold climates, mainly birds and mammals. With the slow decline of giant herbivorous dinosaurs and carnivores, new opportunities opened up for smaller animals that no longer had as much competition. This is how, little by little, mammals began to take an important place in the diversity of species. It is possible that if the meteorite had never fallen, a large part of the dinosaurs would have adapted to the world's new cold climate, but still mammals would have taken a suitable place without other dinosaur species. Simultaneous volcanic eruptions. Another of the most popular theories that could explain the extinction of the dinosaurs is that thousands of years before the meteorite fell on Earth, much of all of the volcanoes on the planet erupted simultaneously. The theory arises from a study conducted in northern China by researcher Lemeng Zhang of the Chinese University of Geosciences in Beijing. The team analyzed ancient sediments at the bottom of a lake basin and found that the lake's temperature had begun to rise hundreds of thousands of years before the impact of the Chicxulub crater, which presumably made the dinosaurs extinct. This warming coincides with the eruptions on the stairs of the Deccan in India. The Deccan stairs are one of the most significant volcanic formations on Earth. They are composed of several solidified basaltic flood layers, covering an area of 500,000 square kilometers and 2,000 meters thick, approximately the area of France. This formation originated approximately 68 million years ago in the area of what is now India, from a large number of volcanic veins that massively opened in the ground and expelled immense amounts of lava uninterruptedly for a million years. Suppose these types of eruptions are replicated simultaneously throughout the planet. In that case, this could cause an increase in greenhouse gases such as methane, carbon dioxide, and sulfur dioxide, which generated a climate change that raised temperatures and intoxicated the oceans, weakening living organisms and killing those that could not adapt. Although the data showed changes in the planet's pre-impact temperature worldwide, the team also discovered something more alarming. Zhang and his colleagues found that many fossils in the ancient sediments disappeared during this sudden warming. Two-thirds of the region's extinction occurred after the onset of volcanism and hundreds of thousands of years before impact. In summary, the studies provide strong evidence that at least 8 million years before the meteorite fell, volcanoes destabilized the global climate in a series of simultaneous eruptions that suddenly raised the temperature across the planet, killing a large part of the species almost immediately. Subsequently, thousands of years after the eruptions began, the smoke caused by soot and sulfur darkened the sky. Eventually, there was a decrease in the temperature of the entire planet. The climate went from being warm and tropical to cold and dry. The plants began to die. The most enormous herbivorous dinosaurs began to decrease by not being able to adapt, as well as the aquatic animals died due to the increase of toxins in the waters, which produced a cascading extinction of all living beings. The final executioner. The extinction of the dinosaurs began much earlier than we thought, and thanks to science, we now know that the changes in the world significantly weakened the species of that time. So for better or for worse, the meteorite that fell on the Earth 66 million years ago was only the cherry on the cake of a series of catastrophes that had begun long before its arrival. In a way, the meteorite only finished extinguishing the dinosaurs already going extinct long before. What would have happened if the meteorite had never fallen on the ground? Do you think it's possible that dinosaurs would have managed to adapt and survive, or would have gone extinct anyway to make way for the mammals that rule the world today? Let us know your opinion by writing your valuable comment.